What's going on, Pisces? Thank you to everyone that's liked, shared, subscribed. If you guys have purchased a reading or if you've donated to my page, I truly appreciate you guys. Thank you. I appreciate each and every one of you. If you are new here, welcome. My name is Renee. If you are returning, thank you guys for finding me once again. Right? I'm so lucky to have you. We're going to dig into Pisces energy. For some of you, you know, I'm on TikTok as well. If you want to find me there, that'd be great. Link up. These days with the YouTube algorithm, TikTok has been treating me way better. You know, I don't know what's going on here. People are not seeing my videos. And if you don't get any notifications that I'm here, guys, please go ahead and unsubscribe and resubscribe so that maybe we can get you back on. To know when I'm here, okay? I would appreciate it. Thank you so much. So let's get into this Pisces energy. All right, so you got somebody that wants to give you a gift. They want to come in, right? They want to see you for the gift that you are. And y'all, I ain't do my nails yet. So look, I don't even feel like it. I've been moving, guys. I'm tired. So please omit my hands. Y'all know I'm a beast about my hands. I will moisturize right now, though. That's what I will do, but right now I don't even feel like painting them, so just please give me some mercy. All right, I know people love my hands, but yeah, they look like a mess right now. I know, I'm sorry. I'm gonna fix them later, I promise. Now back to this reading. Yeah, so they're now looking to see you as the gift that you always were, Pisces. Okay, yep. Could be soulmate energy here. The relationship with this person or whoever they are went stagnant, right? There was no growth, no development because this person was focused on other people. They were doing other people, seeing other people. They were not giving you the time, energy, love, nurturing that you were putting out to them, okay? This is a trigger for you. And guys, if you are triggered by this reading, I do apologize, okay? So go ahead and click off. If you're triggered, I don't want to trigger anyone, but I want to give you the information that I see here, okay? So yeah, so this was a sexual relationship, friends with benefits. This is someone that you had good sex with. The sex was so good that some of you got entangled, right? So in other words, yeah, you know, I want to be with this person. I could see myself having a lifetime with this person. The sex is good. You know, I want to continue to have sex with this person. You know, they do things for me that other people have not. They make me feel things that other people have not. And I really want this to be my person, right? So that vulnerability is there. So you guys are saying, you know what? I want to be vulnerable. I want to give this person my all, but this person is still acting like they don't see me, they don't recognize me, or they don't acknowledge that I'm worthy, that I am a person that they should get down with, like that they should want to be with, type of energy. But Spirit is saying that this is a lesson for you. All right. All right, you guys were feeling like, you know, I don't want to put myself out there. You know, I've had a lot of people mistreat me in the past, but this person here, then it came along to rock my world, and I want to be with this person, right? But this is a lesson, right? This is the same lesson that you've had previously, but just with a different face. And the universe threw in a person that knew all your sexual energy, all your sexual spots. So they gave you a soulmate energy that knew how to take care of you sexually. Okay, there is a thing, right? I could tell you some stories. All right. Some of the stories that I have dealt with when I've met a couple of my soulmates, and I say to myself, how did he know how to do that to me like that? And it's because they have memorized your body from a previous lifetime. It's like they get in there and everything just activates, and it activates for you as well, okay? But it's meant to teach you something. It's meant to bring you to a level of awareness or something that you're missing and something that you need to deal with, my loves, okay? So you guys are in a lesson, right? So you guys are feeling what you feel, right? Opening up and sharing your weakness to this person. And the weakness for some of you is that you're saying, like, I have got to surrender to this person sexually because my body just allows me to. My body just falls in line with this person, right? Now, everything else about this person that should trigger you, is what you're not seeing or what you're saying it could get better, because as long as they still giving me X, Y, and Z, I'm good. But it's not. Okay, so spirit is wanting someone to elevate here. Valuable soul lessons needed to make self whole again. Yes, this is your soulmate coming through, but the soulmate is meant to bring up those insecurities of yours, those vulnerabilities that you're meant to handle here in the here in 3D now land. Okay, so let's continue, guys. Yeah, I just put up a Pisces reading that's a little bit different. That's about the same, though. Some differences, but it's the same on TikTok. So, guys, please go see that. Same name, Embracing Mattress, as well. A little bit different energy, but same type of line here. So, now, look, this person, whoever they are, they're upset because, yeah, they don't want anyone else to have you, right? They don't want anyone else to come in and have those gifts that you've been giving them, right? When they think about you with someone else, they feel kind of miserable. Like, yeah, they're attached to your sexual energy just as you are attached to theirs. But this is a person that's just not willing to just be only in your energy. And that's why everything is stuck and stagnant. Now, this person may have got somebody pregnant, or if this is the other side of the energy, okay, so either a man got someone pregnant, or a woman just found out that she's pregnant or will be finding out that they're pregnant soon. Summertime is here, okay? People are going to be gossiping about this, right? Why? Because there's some sort of issue going on with whatever union this is. And it's possibly because this person, whoever they are, okay, that's coming up in your energy, Pisces, is dealing with multiple people, right? So spirit of the flocks is here. We got gossip, rivals, posses, and I feel like these are the different people that they're dealing with that's going to be upset because everyone's in a stalemate. Nobody's moving forward with this person, except for the person that is in that's going to find out that they're either pregnant or that they're having a child. But even with that, okay, even with that, there's a tragic romance going on. So no one is getting anything from this person that they feel like they want. That's the trigger. Bad news. Thank you, Spirit. Okay, so we have bad news here. I'm the messenger, right? So this person is not, whoever this energy is, they have commitment issues. So they don't want to have a commitment with anyone. They want to be able to roam freely. They want to be able to see who they want. Now, along the way here, yeah, they done slipped up and somebody may be having a child, or someone's going to find out that they're having a child, but this person still wants to remain in the energy that they're in, okay? So this is an unawakened person, and whoever I'm speaking to, Pisces energy, you guys have went through an awakening. So spirit is saying the lesson that you're currently in is for you to not be in this energy, for you to not be waiting for someone to give you what you know that you deserve, okay? For someone here, you're not allowing yourself to detach from this energy so that you can have the love that you deserve. Why? Someone needs to dig deep and try to figure out why you're trying to stay attached to this energy. And what spirit is giving me is that some of you may have had some childhood issues that are causing you, okay? They're telling me to do this. Yep. Childhood issues. Yep, nostalgia. So look, you got some childhood issues that are going on with you right now, that you have not healed or that have not been healed. All right, you may have watched your parents be in some sort of situation, okay, that they shouldn't have been in. Now, when you think about your parents, somebody, and I'm gonna give you why they gave me this music card, because spirit is giving it to me on the back end side. When you think about the happier times with your parents, or you think about times that you saw your parents go through, music is always something that comes up. You're very nostalgic. I'm hearing Al Green. I'm hearing Marvin Gaye. I'm hearing that your parents basically set the tone, the romantic tone in the household, or your, you know, if it was just your mom or your dad or what have you, but you saw that music was intricate in the household whenever there was some type of love or some sort of romance going on. So when you guys think about this person, music could be something that is intense or makes it more intense. You guys could have had sex to music as well. And this is also something that you may have learned from your parents, right? I'm getting now a vision of Baby Boy, the movie, you know, when Tyrese's mother, you know, was with Ving Rhames, that type of energy, okay? But as you guys know, that was also something that was very triggering, because it was the guy, Ving Rhames, his character, he was very violent, right? And I think there was a scene where he was violent, and he apologized, right? And also music was in that scene. So some of you may have had some sort of childhood of that nature, right? To where you have got to heal that energy, or something that you've seen when you was a child, because you're bringing it into your adult relationships. And whoever this person is, right, they may have given you something that you needed, that you were craving, okay, to the point where you were able to, or I won't say able to, but that you allowed yourself to overlook the triggers with this person, or the things that you needed to pay attention to, because you said, you know, they give me this, they take care of me sexually, so I'll be able to get by. But no, Spirit wants you to choose yourself. Spirit wants you to understand the lesson of saying, hey, yes, you can have these different connections with people that you're not meant to be with. They're just meant to come in and either show you something or give you something or remind you of something, okay? So some of us, and me too, you know, when I look back and think about my parents, I understand now what I was meant to see. I understand now, you know, what I was going through. And yeah, some of you may need to deal with that energy, okay? So let's continue. I'm making this longer, I'm sorry, but I just want you to understand what I'm seeing. You know, my job is to help you heal. That's why I'm here, right? It's not to get paid or anything like that, right? I want to grow my station so that you guys can hear the messages from a different perspective. There's a whole bunch of beautiful readers here on YouTube, but all of us do not tell the same messages the same way. So my way of giving you what I need to give you, I hope that it helps you guys. I hope that I have been a vessel for you, okay? So let me give you what else is here for you. And then we're going to end this reading. Thank you, Spirit. Just let it fall. Thank you. All right. Yep. You've been going through a lot of things that require an ending. Okay. And I feel like you've been struggling with ending certain things, you know, and it's because of the connection that you feel that you have with said thing. Now, this could be jobs, this could be people, this could be mindsets, this could be attitudes, this could be habits, etc. Okay. And yes, a lot of you have been dealing with people that have backstabbed you, and they had their own agenda when it came to you, right? You guys are exhausted. You don't want to be a doormat in no one's life. You don't want to be someone that, you know, someone just uses whenever they feel like it. Spirit is saying the ties have to be severed. Okay? It's Gemini energy coming through here. All right? So severing the ties is what gets you to a Wheel of Fortune type of energy. Okay, which would be good luck and destiny. You guys going towards what's really for you, right? You guys actually having a soulmate that's not coming in to give you stuck in stagnant chaos and conflict. This soulmate that needs to come towards you to help you make decisions in life, to help you raise your vibration, to help you do the things that you've came to this 3D to do. The number on this card is number 10. 1 plus 0 is 1, which means the soulmate that's here to give you the new beginning that you deserve, okay? After you've had endings and defeat and that on repeat, right? Your root chakra needs to be healed for some of you, right? So balance is here. Some of you may be dealing with a Sagittarius or have Sagittarius in your chart, right? So spirit is saying balance is here, right? So once you go through what it is, make cut those ties, right? Work on yourself, right? Work on your understanding of how things impacted you from childhood to now, then you'll be in a spot to understand why you accept the types of energies that you do. Okay, so we have perception change here. We have compromise, forgiveness, right? Forgive the people that hurt you. Forgive your parents or the people or grandparents or whoever it is that you saw the dysfunction of their relationships or situationships, right? Also, I have to say that some of you, you have never had the type of attachment that you've wanted. So you've craved to have a relationship or a marriage. And some of you are still in a sense of not having that or not elevating to that level. But Spirit is saying it's okay. Forgive everyone that's ever hurt you now. Forgive people that didn't know that they were hurting you. Forgive yourself for putting yourself into situations that were meant to teach you lessons, right? Someone here has to do this work so that you can get out of this energy. Time heals all wounds, and that is 100% honest, okay? So this is what I have for you guys, Pisces. I'm sending you guys love and light. You guys take care.